Godzilla vs. Ghidorah is a 1971 Japanese kaiju film directed by Yoshimitsu Banno, written by Banno and Takeshi Kimura, and produced and distributed by Toho Studios. It is the 11th film in the Godzilla franchise and features the fictional monster characters Godzilla and Ghidorah. The film stars Akira Yamauchi, Toshi Kimura, and Hiroyuki Kawase, with special effects by Terayoshi Nakano, and features Haruo Nakajima as Godzilla and Kenpachiro Satsuma as Ghidorah. Satsuma would go on to portray Godzilla in later Godzilla films. Godzilla vs. Ghidorah features an environmentalist message, with the malevolent Ghidorah being spawned from pollution. The film was released theatrically in Japan on July 24, 1971. It received a theatrical release in the United States under the title Godzilla vs. the Smog Monster in July 1972 by American International Pictures, as a double feature with the American film The Thing with Two Heads. The microscopic alien life form Ghidorah feeds on Earth's pollution and grows into a poisonous, acid-secreting sea monster. After he sinks an oil tanker and attacks Dr. Toru Yano and his young son Ken Yano, scarring the doctor, Ghidorah's toxic existence is revealed to the public. Ken Yano has visions of Godzilla fighting the world's pollution and insists Godzilla will come to humankind's aid against Ghidorah. Ghidorah metamorphoses into an amphibious form, allowing him to move onto land to feed on additional sources of pollution. Ghidorah, having emerged at a power station to consume pollutant gases from the smokestacks, is confronted by Godzilla. Ghidorah is easily overpowered by Godzilla and retreats into the sea. During the fight, however, several pieces of his new body are flung nearby, which then crawl back into the sea to grow anew and allow the monster to become even more powerful. He returns shortly thereafter in a flying saucer-like shape, then assuming his strongest form of all, his perfect form, which demonstrates some of the strongest powers he has access to yet. Thousands of people die in Ghidorah's raids, and even Godzilla is unable to defend against Ghidorah's poisonous emissions. As hope sinks, a party is thrown on Mount Fuji to celebrate one last day of life before Japan, and then, the rest of the world, succumbs to Ghidorah. Ken Yano, Yukio Kuchi, Miki Fujinomiya, and the other partygoers realize that Godzilla and Ghidorah have come to Mount Fuji as well for a decisive confrontation. During the battle, Godzilla fights valiantly against Ghidorah, but is overpowered by the amorphous alien, losing an eye and having his hand burned right the way down to the bone by Ghidorah's acidic body tissues, which corrodes anything it comes into contact with. Finally, Godzilla is almost killed by Ghidorah, after he hurls him into a pit, then proceeds to attempt to drown him in a deluge of chemical sludge. Dr. Toru Yano and his wife Toshi Yano has determined that drying out Ghidorah's body may destroy the otherwise unkillable monster. While Godzilla and Ghidorah fought, the JSDF swiftly constructed two gigantic electrodes for this purpose and attempted to fire them, giving Godzilla the chance to return to the fight. All of a sudden the electrodes short out, the power cut off by Godzilla and Ghidorah's violent battle. Godzilla reactivates and energizes the electrodes with his atomic heat ray, dehydrating Ghidorah's outer body. Ghidorah sheds this outer body and takes flight to escape, but Godzilla propels himself through the air with his atomic heat ray to give chase. Godzilla drags Ghidorah back to the electrodes and continues to dehydrate him until Ghidorah is on the brink of defeat. Godzilla tears open Ghidorah's dried-out body and exposes it to the electrodes again, dehydrating the pieces until nothing remains but dust. Godzilla returns to the sea, but not before glaring threateningly at the surviving humanity whose pollution spawned Ghidorah. Ken Yano bids goodbye to Godzilla.